to the extent that is possible. When women are not in the mainstream of the church is lacking. That's the vision I have about the church. And I can see reluctance on the part of the women also, lady members of the church also. When I'm giving them the opportunity, they will not come forward. Because of the culture that binds us down to an extent where even now we are male-dominated society. Things are changing. Things are changing. And the church should be a relevant church for our time. This we need to understand very well, not simply because I am telling you. Try to understand with the Spirit of the Holy Spirit, filled with the Spirit of the Holy Spirit. Think about this in God's presence and discern the ways of God. And then try to do whatever is noble, whatever is ideal, whatever is an example for other congregations or parishes in our diocese and also for other Christian denominations. The time doesn't permit me to go at length telling you all about the things that I would love to speak to you about the church, particularly about this diocese, where we need to be a church of the time. But then take time or find time where those things can be spelled out, those things can be taught out clearly, and we also take steps to move forward. Today, when I stand before you, I need to remind you that when you have started the mission project, which is called Hope, you should have wings and then go further. It's not simply allowing them to gather together, but enabling them to understand that they are part of this parish and the parish has a responsibility to do that is possible to do for their development, for them to be part of this church. You can take time later on, or the members of the committee can sit with me to think about ways and means by which we can do this, but this parish has a responsibility. And also let me tell you that this parish has a responsibility regarding the membership of the church. At least 3 years back when I visited this parish, the officials reminded me that the strength is going up. And you know the seating capacity of this parish. And therefore, again, that is a challenge before this parish where you find means by which you cannot deny membership of a Mahatma member coming and asking for membership. But we should take steps where we should be telling them what is to be done, where we can give them support, where we can give them fellowship, where we can say that we grow together in Houston as worshiping communities of the same church called the Mahatma Church. Think about those things. Today I am happy that some of our diocesan office bearers and council members are present in our midst. I once again ask Mr. Chaco Matthew to stand up. He is the diocesan treasurer. Anything that you want to ask him about the diocese or anything that he wants to tell you, take time when you go for the lunch fellowship to meet him. He, along with all others, are grateful to this parish for all the things that you have done in the past for the development of the diocese, and we look forward to have your cooperation in the days ahead. Varghese P. Varghese is in our midst. He is now in charge of the, as a diocesan council member, he is in charge of the memo that we want to publish on the grand finale. And he is collecting the data for the memo from the members who were present in the beginning when we started the diocese, or members who work hard for the establishment of this parish. So he is the person to meet as far as that is concerned. We also have in our midst Mr. Shaji, who is from Philadelphia, representing a region, and he has gone. Okay, he is now helping the diocese to understand what are the things to be done when we give more emphasis to regional work that are to be done. And when I said this regional activities over here, I want to remind this parish that as a diocese, things that are to be done basically for the community in Mexico is done. And now a chapel is also consecrated for their worship. Now the parishes in Houston, both the parishes, this parish and Trinity Matama Parish, you should take the lead to see that the mission activities are going on from strength to strength, day after day. What is most required right now is people visiting them, spiritually giving the nourishment, people who know Spanish, and they are our growing generation, who are born and brought up here, who know Spanish to handle. So I expect the people in these parishes in the Texas region to take up turns to go out there and help the people to be drawn closer to Jesus the Christ. The Mexico mission depends on how best you will take interest in seeing that the mission activities are progressing day after day. As we are here to celebrate the parish day, we are not only glorify the things that we have accomplished in the past, for which we need to be grateful to God, but we are here also to look ahead, to have the right vision, to take our steps, concrete steps, to see that we carry out the mission and the ministry that is given to us. In the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus the Christ said, "You are the light of the world and you are the salt of the world." Light of the world and salt of the earth. God is the true light, and that light is given to us through Jesus Christ. And when that light is given to us, we are placed in various places to be Christ-like, imitating Christ, so that the world will know Christ and receive Him as Lord and Savior through our life, a life that we lead in the places wherever God has placed us. The main characteristics of the salt is to preserve things that may get disintegrated. Things that are disintegrating, the function of the church is to prevent that process of disintegration and to integrate the whole so that the quality will be maintained and that will become useful to the whole universe. So it is the question of going a second mile with Jesus Christ when we understand that we gather together as members of the church knowing Jesus as Lord and Master. It is not simply the question of whether you know Jesus or not. It is the question of living Christ in the places wherever God has placed us. So, the main question that will come to your attention is, are we doing what Jesus Christ wants us to do in the places where He wants us to be His ambassadors? Today we have been reflecting on the Bible portion, and therefore I am not going into the details, but let me tell you two or three things which are important, by which our life can be meaningful. Everybody knows about Father Damien. He became an ordained minister to minister among God's people.